Hi, dear loves, I'm Nicole, and welcome to our spiritual guidance for April 14th, 2017. So, dear loves, I really feel like today, on the eve of Venus going direct, this is an energy where we're being guided to be grateful for the information that's been surfacing from deeply within, from the shadows of who we are. Because those very shadowy energies are really what we don't often want to look at. And when that truth surfaces through our meditation, through our really putting in that spiritual effort of being vulnerable and really receiving this information that comes from people that love us, whether it be your best friend, whether it be your lover, who may be caught up in a love triangle. And, you know, she or he may be choosing between you. You may be choosing between him or her. And that understanding of, do I really want to be with this person? Yes, I do. I'm going to put in all, you know, of me. I'm going to really put in the effort. And do I really want to be with this person? No, I don't. And how do I break up with them? How do I let them know, you know, we don't need to be together? Require different needs, or I see that we were really never meant to be, or I see that yes, you're the love of my life, but it's toxic between us right now, or always has been. You know, sometimes we don't, excuse me, we don't see it right off the top, and spirit gives us these experiences between each other to help us strengthen this part in ourselves. That needs to happen. So then we understand, oh my gosh, this relationship needed to happen. Our reunion needed to happen. And all of this stuff is happening for our soul growth. So there was an amazing truth bomb that surfaced for many of us. And it went both ways, whether we received it as something we didn't really want to hear and something that we needed to hear and wanted to hear. So the whole thing is, though, I really feel strongly for us to be grateful for it, because it really is something that we needed to hear and receive in order to move on. We had to go through the vulnerable stage of really welcoming that shadowy side of who we are, that ego, so that we could balance between our subconscious and our conscious, and our spirit or our soul and our human and our ego. Thank you, Heavenly Angels, so much. It's for growth. It really is growth. And this was a powerfully deep growth spurt for all of us. And, you know, the truth hurts sometimes. And so it really is in that ability to accept it, and to accept really if your relationship is based on physical lust or even not meant to be, it's not in divine timing right now. And this includes twin flame and soulmate connections there that really have been made manifest but need to separate. And that divine masculine and divine feminine separating can be a very excruciatingly painful thing. But we also, again, are understanding this week that truth and, oh my gosh, I thought this was my twin, but he or she really wasn't. He or she was my soulmate that really taught me this lesson to prepare me for my twin. Or this was my life partner that I was with or that I am with. And I know that pull deep inside of me is still seeking out my reunion with my spiritual love. So all of that was really up, and marriage was at the heart of it. Do I really want to be with this person? Do I want to stay in my marriage? Do I want to be married to them? Are they going to marry me? Do we have what it takes? Is the foundation strong? And business partnerships, who am I loyal to? How can I balance out this energy of wanting to stay or wanting to have a smooth transition into my life mission? How are they loyal to me? The job, the person, the people, the career choice. What am I loyal to? Thank you, heavenly angels. Goddess Isis, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you for blessing our journey. Thank you for allowing us to reflect in your energy, helping us see our beauty. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So this is marking, whoa, oh my gosh, okay. Oh, this is a huge week. Huge, huge, huge. So we have two number 10s here, and that's telling us that with 8 and 2 reducing to 10, and with Archangel Michael here gifting us with the wheel, that this was a powerful week of just straight up change. This is positive change. And I'm going to start with Archangel Michael. We have all of the elements at our disposal here. We have this new beginning that we're embarking on with 10. And I encourage you to go to NicoleXO.com and look into the spiritual meaning of the number 10. And we really have begun this new journey, this karmic change. A lot of karmic relationships are breaking, have been shown deeply within our souls that we no longer need to have this union, or we need to separate right now to work on ourselves. We need to focus on our life mission more than our romantic life, or vice versa. And that's a good thing for us to do right now. We've got every element at our disposal. And this is absolutely in our love life as well. We know that the energy is self-directed and very spiritual. And we have every single element here. And we have all of the four winds here, north, south, east, and west. We have water energy, spiritual energy. We have a prosperity of growth and abundance and material gain. We have passionate energy to go on our life mission and to really, you know, be back in love with divine source and with ourselves before with being totally in love with another and balancing that out. We also have that information that we control and how it's going to be delivered. We have our intellect here, our wind energy, and that inward communication there. So that's big. And the fact that we're protected, I mean, this is a green light and going in that direction that that's been revealed to us this week, that it truly is something that's going to propel us forward in a huge way. And I'm sure that many of you are feeling that strong pull of just being, you know, up at the top of the roller coaster ride and knowing that, you know, you're about to go down that steep slope and you don't have control over that. And you're just feeling like, you know, the best thing I can do is be grateful right now and enjoy the process. Honey, this is freedom. This is freedom. It's time to come out of your shell. This shell, which did serve you in the past to provide protection for your tender heart, is no longer needed. The time has come to begin to allow yourself true freedom. This world and your soul both need you to let your light and your heart to shine. Allow the past to be the past and move forward in this present moment. Do this in small steps at first, if you need to. Moving away from your protective shell means allowing your true heart to be seen, but it also means allowing others in on a deeper level than you have been able to allow before. Now that really spoke to many people. And there's that answer of I'm all in. I'm all in. I saw on the Libra full moon, I'm seeing today, I saw yesterday, I'm going to see tomorrow, that through this Venus retrograding cycle that I deserve to be with my husband. I deserve to be with my wife. They deserve me to be all in, where I don't need to be in this toxic relationship anymore, or this toxic energy between us. But I love this person, and I definitely bid them, excuse me, farewell into their own freedom as I receive mine with unconditional love. So this is the right thing to do. We are all starting on this beautiful pathway here with strength. This foundation is very strong that Spirit is blessing us with. We are at the top of that ability to communicate our life mission, our vision, our desires. This is intellectual energy. This is listening to your intuition, but this is communicating from your heart and soul, and you're ready. You're ready. So spread your wings and go in this direction that surfaced this week. Some is going to surface today in a very shocking way, and I feel tomorrow it may as well be, solidified. But this is going to have some twists and turns to it. But here's the thing, that it's a strong foundation. It's great timing to really begin to solidify what those seeds are that you're going to plant on the Taurus new moon for growth, prosperity, financial gain, and abundance. It is that time to move on. You have that strong desire to do that. You long for that twin flame or that soulmate or that lifetime partner that's going to last, that is in divine timing, and you desire to be in your life mission. So this is that energy of you have to step out on faith. You have to believe in yourself, and in believing in yourself is believing in our Creator. This is spiritual growth at its best. You are facing this beautiful, infinite amount of spiritual abundance, and honey, that is life mission, and that is the exalted height of spiritual love. With the Three of Air, it has taken form. It has begun to take shape in your inward reflection there. When Mercury goes direct, by May 3rd, and of course, you've heard me say May 20th to be out of shadow phase. I really believe that. I have felt it. I have seen it. I've experienced it. My clients have experienced it. To please, excuse me, let Mercury go straight into direct mode and out of that hazy energy before really have that ultimate clarity of action going forward, and any breaks and any major discussions there, and where you decide, okay, this is what I'm going to do. Let your whole energy be clear in that. So take that break, meditate profusely, take time to heal from the information that was unearthed this week. It was great sadness for many people, but remember that you're beautiful spiritual superstars. And when it's not in divine timing, I feel like we've all experienced that. Even Darian and I have, we've run as twin flames, both of us have. And, coming back together, desiring for us to really do it right and build, build upon that strong foundation. Sometimes we have to be pulled apart in order to see what we have, to see who we have, and to just see that it's real. It can be that overwhelming. But just know that as you take that time apart, this is time to really honor that unforgiving, excuse me, that forgiving rather energy, and to release the unforgiveness that may have been that toxic energy between you, or just the need to forgive people that really need to have that freedom, and even yourself that you felt you needed to have that freedom, or that you do need to have that freedom. That's a big deal. When you bid the love of your life a farewell, or you let go of a part of yourself, that is a tough transition when a part of you has to die away in order for another part of you to be reborn. But it is very necessary for you to recognize that shadowy side of yourself and of any connection you have with another. This is divine sun child, blessings of the sun falcon. Blessings of the sun falcon. The divine sun child, Horus. This is the son of goddess Isis and Lord Osiris. And that energy is flowing to us now. It is time to allow your life to flourish without limits, to let your light burn bright and without veil, just like the midsummer sun burning without contest in the Egyptian desert. Blessings of the sun falcon herald the time when your divine legacy is being born. It is your time to burn bright. Horus, the divine sun child of Isis and Osiris, was born out of impossible circumstances through the great devotion of his mother, Isis, and her loving determination to heal her husband and bring him back to life, to eventually become king of Egypt, defeating dark forces that would seek to destroy him and all that he loved with great triumph. It is a story of the divine hero of Egypt. This is an energy of values, of healing, of triumph over creativity, over destruction, born of fear and hate. This is understanding that powerful way forward in releasing from the darkness within and between another. Many blessings, dear loves. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And I love you so much. Thank you for your support. April's readings will be out, I believe, later today. So thank you for understanding that they are late for our astrological or zodiac, sun, moon, rising, ascendant, and cusp signs for April 2017. Take great care, and I'll see you soon.